This represents two of the four dimensions. To describe four-dimensional space-time, we need four coordinates, which we will refer to as x0, x1, x2, and x3. The numbers 0 through 3 are index values, not exponents. Einstein's field equations remain valid no matter what coordinate system we choose. None of the coordinates necessarily need to correspond to the time coordinate of any observer. Curved coordinates can also be used to describe flat space-time. In order to better understand the critical concepts, let us first focus on a flat two-dimensional space. The following arrows show the direction in which our position will change if we increment one of the coordinates at various points in space by a small amount. These arrows are what we refer to as the basis vectors. Let's move one of the basis vectors by exactly one unit as shown. The rate at which the basis vector changes is described by the white vector. The white vector can be represented as a linear combination of the two basis vectors at this point. Let's replace the numbers with the following symbols, each of which has three index values. The index value at the top indicates which basis vector is multiplying. The two index values at the bottom indicate which basis vector is moving and in what direction. These symbols indicate the rate at which the basis vectors are changing at each point in space. The basis vectors could be changing because we are using a curved coordinate system in a flat space-time. Or the basis vectors could be changing because we have a curved space-time, even though we have coordinates as straight as possible. Suppose we have a curved four-dimensional space-time with coordinates as straight as possible, where x0 represents time and x1 through x3 represent the three spatial dimensions. In situations where Newtonian physics gives accurate approximations, the acceleration due to gravity is approximately equal to the following symbols related to the curvature of space-time. In these cases, the gravitational acceleration is approximately equal to the rate at which the basis vector for time changes as it moves forward in time. This change is due to curvature.